again, presented by Nirmala Sitharaman on July 5th. First, I'm going to say about missions of decades. Building Team India with Jan Bhagirathi, Minimum Government Act, Minimum Government, Maximum Governance. Achieving Green Mother Earth and blue skies through the pollution-free India. Making Digital India reaches every sector of the economy. Launching the Gaganyaan, Chandrayaan, other space and satellite programs. Building physical and social infrastructures. Direct tax. Tax reduced to 25% for companies with annual turnover of ₹400 crores. Surcharge increase on individual having taxable income from ₹2 crores to 5 crores and ₹5 crores and above. India's ease of doing business ranking under the category of paying taxes jumped from 172 in 2017 to 121 in 2019. Direct tax revenue increased by over 78% in the past 5 years to ₹11.37 lakhs crore. Now I call upon Joshua to proceed.
Good morning, I am Joshua and I am going to speak about towards $5 trillion economy. Our Union Minister of Finance and Corporate Affairs, Shri Nirmala Sitharam, said that people's hearts are filled with hope, trust and aspirations. She conveyed that Indian economy should become a $3 trillion economy in the current year and $5 trillion economy in 2024 and 2025. She said that India Inc. are India's job creators and nation's wealth creators. She emphasized the need for infrastructure. She emphasized the need for investment in infrastructure, digital economy and job creation in small and medium firms. She said that 50 lakh crore of investment is needed in railway infrastructure during 2018 and 2030. She proposed PPP, public-private partnership for development and completion of railways, railway stock manufacturing and for passenger and freight services. She also prepared a regulatory roadmap for making India up for aircraft and financing and leasing activities from India source. Then I call upon Avishu to speak in the shop.
Good morning everybody. My topic is opposition of Union Budget. The Congress on Friday described Union Budget 2019 as an inspired and called finance and called Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman's speech as an unusual awake exercise. Addressing a press conference at a party headquarters, former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram said the budget has not been prepared without listening to the ordinary citizens or knowledgeable economists. Instead of providing meaningful relief to any section of people, Finance Minister chose protectionist measures like hiking custom duties or exploitative moves like imposing a cess on petrol and diesel, he said. The former Finance Minister expressed surprise at details like total expenditure, total revenue was not a part of Sitharaman's speech. There are large number of people who are listening to the speech and they do not get any document. Why are they keeping people in dark? I think it's unfair to not let them know of this number, he said. My request you miss all to say about green budget.
Good morning, I am going to speak about green budget. Trinamool Congress leader Derek O'Brien said it's a green budget while the government is still reselling goods and not delivering. FDI in media aviation and more benefits to foreign insurance intermediaries means government has introduced concept of selling. The Telugu Desam Party Lok Sabha core leader K. Ramohan Naidu said the budget looks more like a book of quotations. The interim budget had covered more aspirations of people compared to the actual budget. Maybe because of the government was seeking a re-relation. Jobs and issues of job creation has not been addressed in policy terms. He added Mr. O'Brien also said that since the railway budget is subsumed in the union budget, very little attention is given to the sector. The challenges Sitharaman faces are many. Gross domestic product growth slumped to a 5-year low of 5.8% in the January-March quarter, as India lost its tag of the world's fastest growing economy to China. Meanwhile, it was officially confirmed that unemployed has touched a 45-year high. The signs are clear that there is a rural slowdown, consumption and demand are suffering. debt, investment still remains muted. Sitaraman will look to boost domestic consumption, address the rural crisis and support micro, small and medium enterprises.
Thank you.